the greatest trust between two human beings is the trust of counsel, isn't it? So when two people are seeking counseling, then it is imperative that those people should not share or exchange words by a textbook. Hi, I'm Dimple Ghosh and I am your mental groomer. Yes, you heard it right. I am the mental groomer. Through this series, I'm going to share with you my observations and my experiences of the last 25 years of what I've been through so that I can help you give back my experiences, my observations and take you through a lovely ride of life. So if you want to know more, then you stay till the end of the episode, because here's when I'm going to share with you the 5 amazing steps to tackle today.
Negative emotions, just like positive ones, are a natural reaction to emotional stimuli, right? So these reactions can't always be coined as the scientific term for mental sickness or spiritual bankruptcy.
The synopsis of the series is basically my personal experiences and my copyrighted experiences, whatever that means. Yes, it means that these are solely my experiences, my observations and my tribulations. So no one can claim it, okay? So I'm not a counselor, I'm not a psychiatrist, but I am the one who has experienced all those things that you're experiencing right now. So what am I here for? I'm here to actually give you this hand. Yes, take my hand and let's walk through this beautiful journey together, right?
It's hard to believe that I survived cancer. It's hard to believe that I've been clinically depressed. It's also hard to believe that I've had zero bank balance, right? Yeah, I know it's hard to believe. And you know what? I believe identifying a problem is too textbooky.
So, if I want to mentally groom you, then I have to find an approach which has to be towards adopting a thought process that empowers you. It empowers you to tackle problems better, and rather than dissecting problems and making it into a worse problem, right?
Empowering is not a step per se. It is adopting your inner strength and leveraging it.
Yeah, your inner strength to be ready. When life poses a negative experience, what do? We become negative. But if we turn it around into a positive experience or a positive feeling, it will change. Trust me. How are you going to do it? I'm going to walk you through and take you through every step of how to make negative experiences, negative feelings to positive ones. That's my promise. I don't want to advise you on, you know, the same old self-help crap which sounds extremely lovely in textbooks and, you know, it's really nice to read it. But when it comes to implementation, it's extremely difficult to implement it. But that's where my personal experiences come in, right? And how I had combated it. How did I feel at that time? If I don't share that openly with you, then how will I help you? And that's exactly the way I'm going to help you, and I'm going to heal you through this process. So stay right here, because that's what's coming up. The two most important factors that actually brings about what is it to overcome your miss.
The iceberg metaphor. So the iceberg metaphor is basically when a ship is sailing to a foreign land, and if it is surrounded by icebergs, what happens is that you get to see the tip of the iceberg, and some of the iceberg tips are basically hidden by the tides and the water around it. But the most important part of the iceberg is the foundation, which is completely beneath the surface, which you can't see at all. So what I'm trying to say out here is, you know, our issues, our main issues and its repercussions are visible or observable only in the surface. The real root is always beneath the surface, and that is something that we need to pull out and take out. Now, how will I be able to help you if you're not going to address it? We have to address the real root cause of the problem, and that is the iceberg metaphor. That it comes, it goes, you can see it, you can't see it. All of that is very complex and it's very difficult to understand. You yourself, or me, myself, can help myself and you can help yourself. I can only guide you, But the deep-rooted cause is something that you have to share with me over an email. You have to directly message me on a messenger, on Facebook or Instagram, and share with me your problems. You can even leave your comments below and you can share with me. And if you feel that it's too private to discuss it, email me. Let me know when we can do a live chat and I'll come back and we can do a lovely Q&A about this. The two most important factors that we are always applying when it comes to our miseries, when it comes to our problems. One is the Pareto principle, which is 80-20 always. So 80% is not discussed, 20% may be discussed. Then you have the tip of the iceberg and the iceberg metaphor, where you can only see the tip of the iceberg, but you can't see the foundation where the iceberg came from. And these are important factors. It's very important to help you. And I want to help you. So I'm hoping that the 10-part series that I'm going to be showcasing in this YouTube platform, in the Mental Groomer series, season 1, is going to be very, very important. And I'm going to share with you the 10-part that I'm going to be focusing on in the next 10 episodes. Every week on a Monday, I'll be uploading each episode and I will be focusing on all these 10 pointers. Coming right up. Stay tuned. I am so happy that you are still here, which means that you are on your road to success. You want to heal. You want to become like me. I can't be more happy than what I'm feeling right now. So today's most important part was, and the episode is totally dedicated to addressing and accepting our issues and problems. I did mention two very important points which I believe are interrelated to each other. One is the Pareto principle, which is where we see the 80-20 ratio, which is that most of us have this habit of not discussing our problems, not addressing our issues, and what we do is we 80% of it is hidden and 20% of it is actually looked into. But that's not observable. That is, can't be seen. So how can anybody help you, or how can you help yourself if you're going to just brush it aside or, you know, just put it under the ground? It's not going to help you, correct? And the most important one is, which I feel a great metaphor, is the iceberg metaphor, where when you are in a boat and you're sailing and you see this iceberg, when you see the iceberg, what you can see is the tip of the iceberg. Most of the iceberg is hidden away by water, or the foundation of it can't be seen. So here the metaphor is basically directly indicated towards you. We are surrounded by people who create a huge influence on us, and that's why we try to cover our problems. We don't like to share our problems or get into the deep-rooted cause of it, because we are wondering, you know, what the world is going to think, or what is, array, don't think about the world, think about yourself. You really need to heal. You really need to get out there and become that amazing person that you always were. Okay, you are kind of closing yourself right now. So I have four very important questions that I'm going to shoot out right to you. If you have a pen and paper, please write them down, address them, accept them, yes, no, whatever, with a little bit of explanation would be great. So just do that. Write down these four very, very important questions that I'm going to read out from my notebooks, which I feel is very, very important for you to address. I need you to think about this. I need you to really ponder about it, because it is for your betterment that I'm going to ask you these questions. Okay, so question number one. Have you been noticing that there is something different about yourself in the past few months? If yes, write down yes. If no, then no. But if there is a slight chance of yes, if somebody has told you that, you know, you don't feel like that person I knew, you don't look like that person I knew, you are not behaving like that person I knew, you have changed. If people are saying this and pointing it out to you, there must be something different. If you're feeling different, there must be something different. You need to address this and you need to accept this. Write this question down, answer it, and say what are the changes that you're seeing in yourself, okay? Question number two have actually 10 very important points. So do write them down, because they are very, very important. Have you been seeing that you have these 10 very, very important things, or some of them out of the 10 that feature in your life right now in your behavioral pattern? Okay. Number one, have you been feeling rejected? Have you been feeling sad? Have you been feeling humiliated? Have you been feeling extra emotional? Have you been feeling extra sensitive, or even not extra?
Have you been feeling all of that? Have you been feeling that, you know, your behavior has become a little erratic, or you have become irrational, or you're finding other people irrational? Whatever. It's something, right? Write it down. Okay. The next thing is, have you been noticing mood swings? Have you also been seeing that there is a little bit of drama and tantrum in and around you or by you? So if you have been noticing these pointers, please write them down. Rewind my episode, come to this point and write down these questions again. Answer them truthfully, honest to your heart. Okay? Then I want you to address one more thing. Have you been feeling lonely? Have you been feeling that you don't want to meet the world? Have you been closing yourself, becoming into your closed shell, or just wanting to avoid people, go out, meet your friends, family? Have you just become a loner? Have you been feeling suicidal? Have you been feeling that, you know, the best answer to this world would be if I can, you know, just kill myself? If you're feeling any of all these feelings, and if there are more pointers that you can think that I'm also feeling this, suddenly I'm feeling that, mention it to me. Share it with me over an email, and trust me, I'm going to address them all, because I felt all of this. I felt each and every of this and more. And I have experienced them, personally absorbed them. So I know how it feels. You need me, because I didn't have anybody. Yes, I did. That I'm going to share with you in another episode. But I also had my own brains. I had my own mind. I had my family around that I felt that I cannot betray. And if you're feeling that, then you need to write in to me and I'm going to help you, because that's why I'm here, right? Okay, so moving on. The third important question: are you making all of these above into a habit? Have you started to victimize yourself? Are you taking that route? If you're remotely thinking about dwelling on this and taking that route, please write it down. Please write it down. Share it with me. I'm here to help you. And question number four, which is the last question, but a very important question. All these things is something that you have already addressed, accepted, known, and now you're researching about it, and that's why you're here. Is that so? Have you been going to Google? Have you been going to YouTube? Have you been going to Facebook or whichever social media platform to find out more about mental disorders, or just generally feeling lonely, feeling sad, and how to overcome it? Well, I am so proud of you that you're here today, right place, right time. Give yourself a really nice pat on your back, because brave, brave, that's what I call you, superly brave, okay? Bravo and amazing. You're here because you want to heal. You're here till the end of this episode, which means that you really want a change in your life for the better. If so, then write in to me. I've mentioned it over and over again. I don't want to be repetitive, but you know what you have to do. You have to write down these questions. You need to see my episode one more time or many more times to write down the questions. Questions is something that I need to see the answers of. Okay? So please send in your answers, write your comments, tell me what you think of this episode. You know what? I feel absolutely elated, ecstatic, and on top of the world that I was finally able to be of any help to any one of you out there. And if I was, then write in to me to my personal email address, or directly contact me on my Facebook Messenger, or DM me on Instagram. It's all up to you how you want to communicate with me. I'm here only to help you, and you know that, right? So I'm going to be sharing much more to you in the next 9 episodes that are going to be coming, and it's going to be almost like a coaching and a grooming class as well, which is going to help you through your mental issues as well as all the issues that you have, not only mental but generally just stresses, just somebody you need to talk to, somebody you need, because I, you know, there were a lot of times that I didn't have people, and I feel for you guys out there who need me. So if you need me, and if you think that I'm the right person for you, then contact me. Until next week, Mental Groomer saying bye bye, and please, please, please love yourself and take care of yourself.